Welcome to Columbia Catholic Ministry. Now, here's your weekly update from Father Dan O'Reilly.
The Second Commandment is you shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. In vain means for no reason. All things are vanity, Kohelet tells us in the Old Testament. God gave his name as a gift to Moses, I am. Also known as the Tetragrammaton, it's really just four letters, which are usually transcribed YHWH. We don't even know how it was pronounced. It was considered so holy, it was never spoken. So we don't know if it was Yahweh or Jehovah or some other variation. Even in the Old Testament, they would substitute words like Adonai or Elohim to substitute for the name of God because it was considered so holy, you would never want to say it by accident or for no good reason. In the New Testament, we've been given a new holy name, the holy name of Jesus. There's even a long-standing practice in the church of bowing our heads whenever the name is said. It's a gift. Imagine being on a first-name basis with the Almighty. It's an incredible thing that we can speak to God even without a title. It's not Mr. God, it's not Dr. Jesus, we're on a first-name basis with the divine. So we're all called to recognize how sacred that gift is and to use it only in prayer and under special circumstances. Some people say they get into the habit of invoking God's name in a bad way or using any kind of swear words. Well, think about this for a moment. How often do you swear in front of your parents or your grandparents or your teachers or your bosses or professors? If you say, well, I've never sworn in church, that means you can control it. Because when you know you're in a sacred place, you know how to behave in a better way. So if we remember that God is always around us, we remember that God's name is always sacred, and we should always watch our words and what we say.